Hi everybody, Lynn Burke here with MajorLeagueFishing.com with DeFoe, one of the great anglers on the Bass Angler Sportsman Society circuits. Eastern guy, my old home state of Tennessee is where you hail from. Welcome to Major League Fishing, Ott.
Thank you, Lynn. I appreciate it.
Now, you know, one thing that a lot of these guys in Major League Fishing, they're power guys. You know, you got Kevin Van Dam, and he's cranking and throwing jerk baits and spinner baits. Yep. And you got Kelly Jordan, and he's throwing swim baits. And you got the jig guys and all that. And then you got Aaron Martins. Aaron's doing that ding, 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 the drop shot and the shaky head and all that. You really like to do that. And the shaky head is kind of one of your go-to things. So tell me why I should be more interested in the shaky head technique.
Well, it is one of my go-to things, especially in Major League Fishing, due to the fact that every fish counts.
Right.
You know, so on the other tournament circuits where we fish, five big fish is all that really matters. In this, every scoreable bass you get to count. So for me, I'm going to gear up a little bit differently. I'm going to use, whenever I do crank, it's probably going to be with a smaller bait. I love to fish crankbaits, though it's one of my all-time favorite ways to do it. But a lot of times I'm doing that with a fairly big bait. But shaky heads, man, they get a lot of bites. They catch a lot of fish. They can absolutely catch some big fish. But, man, it's about getting a lot of bites and catching a lot of scoreable fish.
Talk to me about this setup. One of the things I think that scares guys like me away, first of all, it's something that I have never really done a lot of. Mm-hmm. I've played around with it, but I'm not confident in it. And it may be because I'm not sure I've got it set up properly. So how do you set up a shaky head rig?
The biggest thing for me, of course, it's going to be on a spinning rod, number mm-hmm. one. Anything that you're doing that's truly finesse, you want to have on a spinning rod. For me, I'm always going to have braided line with a fluorocarbon leader. That, man, it just makes such a huge difference in how effectively you can fish really any soft plastic rig on a spinning rod. You cast so much further, you have so much better sensitivity, but then you have the benefit of it being invisible under the water with your fluorocarbon leader. So having usually about a 10-pound test braid and six, eight, or 10-pound test leader, depending on the conditions where you're at, the structure, all that kind of stuff. But that for me, and having to have those two things put together is super important. Depending on what I'm fishing around, again, a 6.5 to a 7, maybe a 7'2" rod is what I like for shaky head fishing. And a size 30 reel, a little bit bigger reel than what some people may think.
Why is that?
It's a little bit faster. That's mm-hmm. what you want. So, you know, you've got a little bit of slack in your line. You feel a bite. You can take up that line faster, set the hook in the fish. And a lot of times the fish are in real shallow water. Once you set the hook, buddy, they're coming at you. Mm-hmm. So you've got to have a fast reel to keep up with them. That's my general deal. On the average, the size I'm going to start off with is the 1/8 ounce shaky head. The actual lead on the jig, an 1/8 ounce head. I use one that's got a 4-aught hook in it, just mm-hmm. a round bend hook, and it's got a little barbed keeper up on the shaky head to hold your worm in place. That's what I use. And kind of depending on where I'm at again, either a 4.5-inch or 6.5-inch straight tail worm. And you can really never go wrong with green pumpkin.
I was just about to ask on the color. Now let's talk about the actual technique itself. Mm-hmm. You've got it set up, you've got everything in place.
Yep.
How do you make it sing in the water and get the fish to bite?
It's honestly about doing as little as possible for the most part, because you are finesse fishing. You're not power fishing. You're not trying to make a fish bite. You're just showing the fish something there. Here it is all of a sudden in front of his face. It's not obtrusive. It's not obnoxious. It's just here gliding along. You might as well pick it up. So for me, it's a pretty simple retrieve. I throw it out. I let it go to the bottom on an open bail slack line, number one most important. You got to let that bait get straight down, get on the bottom, mm-hmm. let it get in front of the fish. And then after that, I'm going to kind of bounce it. I'm not just shaking it like I'm trying to shake the devil out of something, but I'm just going to ease it along, just kind of barely, almost barely bumping the bait, you could say. And if I'm fishing a steep bank, I'm going to do that, and I'm just going to try to move it an inch at a time so it can fall off to the next ledge. If I'm fishing a place that's flatter, I'm gonna kind of just drag it along, almost like you would a jig or maybe a Carolina rig, just kind of dragging that bait along the bottom. But if I'm fishing steeper banks, which I tend to do a lot with the shaky head type deal, I'm going to just bounce it a little bit till it falls off the next ledge. Bounce it again, let it fall again. And you'll find the zone that those fish are in. You know, if it's 5 to 10, 10 to 15, whatever it may be, then you can key on those depth range.
Now you mentioned the worm, and you like a straight worm. Is there any particular, does does a brand come into play because of, say, the softness of mm-hmm. the soft plastic? I mean, does it get that technical?
For me, I always use a Berkeley bottom hopper is what I'm going to use, whether it's a bottom hopper or a bottom hopper junior are the two worms that I use whenever I'm shaky head fishing. On occasion, I may put a creature bait on it, you know, something that resembles a crawdad a little bit more, like a pit boss junior, one of those type of baits. But mm-hmm. for me, that straight tail bottom hopper worm, man, that's as good as it gets.
You know, the technique has been around for a while, but a lot of guys aren't comfortable with it. How do you develop a comfort level? How do you develop confidence with it?
It's the same as any technique. You put that rod in your boat and go to the lake and use it. But you also want to go to a lake where it's going to work. You don't want to go to a place that's a mud hole that has this much visibility that fish have only ever been caught on a crankbait or a jig and go try to learn how to fish a shaky head. You want to go to a place that's fairly clear. It's got a lot of fish in it. You know, kind of set it up to where you know they're going to be biting a shaky head, then go get some confidence in it. But put that bait in your boat, grab a bunch of jig heads, grab some worms, and go to the lake.
Is there a time of the year that it's going to be more effective than others?
For me, it's a spawn, post-spawn is whenever I like it the best. That's when I tend to get a lot of bites on it. The fish can kind of be in a little bit of a funk then. You really need something more finesse to get a lot of bites. And so that's when I like to use it the most. I like it whenever the fishing's a little bit tougher. If the fishing's good, I like to do other things. You'll probably catch bigger fish on other things. But whenever they're spawning, or a lot of fish have just got done spawning, starting to move back out, they're not out on deep structure yet. They're not on the bank anymore. They're kind of in that in-between zone. That's when it pays off for me.
And you just mentioned another reason that I've kind of shied away. Again, not that I haven't, you know, tried it, but I like big fish.
Yep.
Can you catch big fish on a shaky head?
You can absolutely catch big fish on a shaky head. There's no doubt about it. I've caught a lot of really big smallmouth at home, actually off of the bed on a shaky head. That's one of the best things to get them to bite. But you can catch them just fishing down the bank. You can catch great big fish. I've done it. I've seen it done, and I've done it in tournaments where, you know, on big fish type places, but it's tough fishing, but you can still catch really big fish on a shaky head.
So is this the ultimate antidote for the tough bite?
It's really close. I would say for the toughest of bites, a drop shot probably beats it, and the clearest of water, a drop shot probably beats it. But anywhere that you've got like 2 to 5 feet of visibility, I'm probably going to pick up a shaky head first.
Can you remember a fish? Can you remember a tournament? Can you remember maybe just a fun fishing outing where you're like, yeah, and it's a memory that mm-hmm. keeps putting a smile on Ott's face?
Actually, my first major league fishing event that I fished, I was able to win that round, and it was due largely to a shaky head. And there was a key fish during the day, about a 3-pounder in a stump, really the kind of fish you're not supposed to get in on 10-pound line, and I did. But then right at the end of the event, right at the end of the round, I caught several key fish just bam, bam, bam on a shaky head.
Which brings up an interesting question. I think I remember that round, and if I remember correctly, the wind was howling that day.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have thought that was a day that you were going to be very successful with a shaky head.
It really didn't seem like it. It sure didn't. And the first couple periods weren't. But as we got further along in the day, the wind just got to be... It was good in the mornings. It was beneficial. It got to be too much. It truly just over-muddied those banks that I'd been keying on in the mornings with power-type techniques. And I just basically had to abandon that, look for something out of the wind, someplace I could kind of settle down and fish a little bit. The whole lake had fish in it. Every lake has fish in it. And I had to just find somewhere where I could just settle down, pick up something else, and kind of pick a few off.
All right. Ott DeFoe, he is one of Major League Fishing's hottest new stars, and you'll be seeing that on television before too long. If you want to learn more about Ott and techniques like the shaky head, go to MajorLeagueFishing.com.